In this lecture, we want to understand the rigid joint, which is another common type of kinematic joints. Then we will have an example, which includes a rigid joint, together with also some revolute and prismatic joints, just to review previous materials. Finally, we will extend our formulation to see how the number of rigid joints might affect the degrees of freedom in a system. Let's demonstrate a rigid joint. Imagine we have two rigid bodies like this and this one. Generally, they have 3 degrees of freedom with respect to each other. If we consider one of them as a reference, the other one can move relative to the reference in 3 ways. 2 translations, x and y, and 1 rotation, theta. When these 2 bodies are rigidly connected, or better to say, welded to each other, like this, they will lose all the 3 possible degrees of freedom between them. No translation and no rotation. Therefore, every rigid joint eliminates 3 degrees of freedom from a system. Let's see an example. We have a rigid body which brings 3 degrees of freedom. Then another rigid body which adds 3 more. When they are rigidly welded together, the system loses 3 degrees of freedom. Because with this new rigid joint, the bodies cannot move relative to each other anymore. Now the system has 3 degrees of freedom, just like a rigid body. So we can conclude that whenever 2 bodies are welded together, they might be considered as 1 rigid body because such a system has 3 degrees of freedom, just like a normal rigid body. Anyway, let's add a prismatic joint here, such that this part can only move along this horizontal direction on the ground. This way, we lose 2 more degrees of freedom, which was taken by the prismatic joint. Up to this point, our system has 1 degree of freedom, which is this sliding motion. Let's assume this big body has a slot on it and a slider should move along this slot, which of course brings 3 degrees of freedom. And because of the prismatic constraint, the system loses 2 more degrees. Now the degrees of freedom is 2, 1 translation here and 1 sliding motion here. Finally, let's have 1 more link here, which adds 3 degrees. From one end, it is pinned to the slider. And from the other end, it is pinned to the ground. For each of those last revolute joints, we will lose 2 more degrees, or 4 degrees in total. Therefore, the degrees of freedom of the system is 1. Now let's extend our formulation to also include the influence of the rigid joint. So we remember that the degrees of freedom was 3 times number of bodies minus 2 times J1. J1 is the number of joints that permit 1 degree of freedom. Now we can say minus 3 times J0. J0 is the number of rigid joints. 0 because it allows 0 degrees of freedom. And 3 times J0 because each of them eliminates 3 degrees of freedom. Let's give it a try for our example. In fact, we have 2 options. Option number 1, we can assume 4 bodies. 1, 2, 3, 4. J1 is 4 because we have 2 revolute and 2 prismatic joints. J2 J0 is 1 since we have only one rigid joint. Substituting 3 times 4 minus 2 times 4 and minus 3 times 1, which becomes 1. And option number 2, if we consider the two welded bodies as one rigid body, then the number of bodies is 3 instead of 4. But we don't need to count that rigid joint anymore. So this time 3 times 3 minus 2 times 4 becomes 1, which is the same result. That's all for the rigid joint. Now that we have experienced the revolute, prismatic and rigid joints, let's do some practice activities after this lecture.